gone over how to properly hold the violin in the first video. So in this video, we're going to go over a good bow grip. And sometimes I feel that the bow grip is just so essential in proper violin playing. It's almost overlooked sometimes. It's as though we play two instruments rather than the one. And the bow is critical. Good expression coming from the bow comes from the fingers. And we need that. If we're stiff, we won't produce that sound and that feeling that we need to express ourselves when we play. So for beginners, we generally hold it with our thumb here, but for beginners, we're going to place our thumb on the silver piece of the frog. I like to use animals. I'm going to place this down for a second. I like to use jungle animals with the children to help them understand. So the middle two fingers are going to be the monkeys, and we're going to be really loose. I would say if you imagine when you wake up in the morning and you look at your hand, take a look at it, and your hand should be nice and loose and fingers curled. We don't squeeze and we don't straighten. We just leave it relaxed. And if we take that position this way and hang our fingers down, there's our bow grip. So there's nothing everybody says, oh, it feels so uncomfortable and it's achy. And it shouldn't be. It should be very loose and relaxed. Take those middle two fingers, take your monkeys and hang them over. The most important part is that the tips of your fingers here, the pad, touches the frog. There's usually an eye or a symbol here. Place that ring finger right there. Now your monkeys are hanging. There is going to be space. We don't want this. We don't want the wrist dropped. Pinkies are birdie. The birdie is going to sit on top of the stick. And the snake right here is going to wrap around. And when he wraps, generally on this black and white line here, the spiraling and the leather, we're going to just wrap it a little bit sideways. I'll always say that this is the eye of the snake. Make sure that the snake is looking at you. Again, the pads of my fingers and the tip of my pinky are touching. That leaves my knuckles free to move as they need to. The thumb underneath, I call him Mr. Bumpity Bump. If he is wrinkled, he doesn't look happy. So we want him to be nice and curled. Place him right underneath that frog. Hang those monkeys over. Wrap the snake around, snake eye looking at you, and the birdie in the nest. There's a good bow grip. There's a nice space in here, as though there's an imaginary ball right there in your hand. And with that, we can use our pinky to do little pinky push-ups and exercise the seesaw, lifting the stick up and down. We can rotate the wrist back and forth, windshield wipers. We can stir the soup. We can use our wrists and our fingers as we do it. And as they get older, their thumb will then go between.